The new Apple iPhone 12 is set to be incredible, and I'll be sharing the details right after this. If you new stay up to date with the latest tech, please subscribe by the bow. You can also keep up on Facebook and Twitter by clicking the links in the description. 2 weeks since my last video, and unfortunately we don't have as much news as we usually do. This still plenty to go over: design leaks, new feature information, and further news about the production of the Apple iPhone 12. Before get into it though, please like the video if you are looking for to the iPhone 12. Let me know in the comments what model you guys want the most. We start with probably the most talked about, and this is of course the prototype from MikroTik era. Strange enough, he's posted this prototype, the supposedly the successor to the iPhone 12. I'm not sure this really been any information to go on here, and it seems like just an attempt to drum up some interest. The reason many blocks of jump on this is of course the use of a USB Type-C cable in the video, but for now I would ignore this as it's really not based on factual information. And to further add to that, even if this was from a leaked prototype, the design will most likely be changed a few more times before its finalization anyway, as well as this will likely to start seeing more concept renders like this one as well. To remember that they are just concepts, or some people claim that the real many people are simply making them because they enjoy bringing their ideas to life, as we have had to just accept it for what it is. It's a concept, and it's not claimed to be rail back to the iPhone 12 that we now certain of the design and specs. Most of you already know the details. One thing that has been uncertain though is of course the date. 12 should have been released in September. It was intended for models of the iPhone 12 to be released at the same launch event. Because of obvious reasons, people have been reporting delays, and many suggesting the Apple iPhone 12 can be about an online only launch event in October. This has further been confirmed by Paul. Yesterday made many comments about the Apple iPhone 12. The CEO for Comm suggested that that would be a major product cycle delay. Large North American mobile phone company. Of course he didn't mention Apple by name, but it's very likely he was discussing the iPhone 12. There were also reports for different variants to be released at different times. When there's no confirmation, it doesn't pay for models will at least be yours in the same online event. 12 is of course can come with iOS 14. This will in turn bring new features, whatever no doubt be many improvements. We would have news of the clips feature that actually allows you to use an app without fully downloading it, is to work as a sort of floating cognitively, just makes things much smoother than they currently. We also have news that Safari will have a built-in translator for use on websites similar to Chrome. We also get pencil support on websites for those of you with older iPhones. We also have some great news that apparently if your device currently has iOS 13 will support iOS 14 meeting. Even if you got it iPhone 6 as you be getting the latest update for those of you that do on the detailed specs for each device in the range. We already have information on all four models of the iPhone 12, my regular viewers, and you guys have already seen this, so just skip to the next video. But if you and you had to make sure you hit subscribe, we'll get right into it. Start with the entry level model of the Apple iPhone 12, and this of course can be called the iPhone 12 to 5.4 inch iPhone with an outlet supervising the display from Samsung. It's important to note straight off the bat, this super bright is not meet absolutely nothing, so don't get too caught up on that, but it's going to be an owner display at a resolution of 2340x1080, which gives us 475 pixels per inch and has an 8-bit color depth. Though have been rumors of models having a 120Hz display. Unfortunately this model is 60Hz only. It can be equipped with 4GB of RAM, and the choice of 128 or 256 storage is made of an atom in your body, and of course use the A14 Bionic with 5G support. The iPhone 12 comes with a dual camera setup on the way, and it will of course be shipping with iOS 14. For those of you that when the iPhone 12 with 4GB of RAM and 128 storage could be launching at $649. If you want 4GB of RAM and 256 storage at $749. Next up, the iPhone 12 Max. To be clear, this is the Max and not the Pro Max. 12 Max is a 6.1 inch only display. This is again a Super Retina over the display provided by Chinese manufacturer Bo. It comes with a resolution of 2532x1170. This gives us a 460 pixels per inch and has an 8-bit color depth. We have 4GB of RAM and the choice of 128 or 256 storage, and of course the iPhone 12 Max is powered by the A14 Bionic chip. Alum in your body, it's good 5G connectivity. We get another dual camera set up on the RAM for those of you that will. The 128GB version of the iPhone 12 Max will be launching at $749 from the 256GB version. It rises to $849 next up. The iPhone 12 Pro. 12 Pro has a 6.1-inch display, so it's actually the same size as the iPhone 12 Max. Food court and improved display and specs on the iPhone 12 Pro report 6.1-inch Super Retina display with ProMotion and a 10-bit color depth. The display is manufactured by Samsung. It's got a resolution of 2532 by 1170, which gives us 460 pixels per inch. This, of course, a 120Hz display. The iPhone 12 Pro comes with 6GB of RAM and a choice of 128, 256, or even 512 internal storage. Of course, chip with Apple's A14 Bionic, and the iPhone 12 Pro is 5G compatible to come to the stainless steel party. And on the rear, we get a triple camera setup with a light sensor for the depth of the 128GB iPhone 12 Pro. It's launching at $999 for 256GB. It's $1,099, and for those that will the 512GB iPhone 12 Pro, it's $1,299. Last but not least, we have the iPhone 12 Pro Max. 12 Pro Max comes with a 6.7-inch outlet display. Again, it's a Super Retina with ProMotion 10-bit color depth, and of course, it is manufactured by Samsung. Go to resolution of 2778x1284, minus 458 pixels per inch. And again, it's a 120Hz display. It comes with 6GB of RAM and a choice of 128, 256, 512 storage. Stainless steel body, and the iPhone 12 Pro Max is of course powered by the 14 Bionic with 5G support, just like the iPhone 12 Pro. Get a triple camera setup on the red one with the additional light sensor for those of you that will. The 128GB iPhone 12 Pro Max is launching at $1,099 for the 256 conversion, is $1,199 for those on the most expensive in the range of 512GB iPhone 12 Pro Max is launching at a whopping $1,399. Of course, there's plenty more information on the Apple iPhone 12 run through it will now, my regular viewers, that you guys would have already seen this, so just switch off now. But for anyone you have, make sure you hit that subscriber marketing, get right into it, expecting to get for a new iPhone 12 in the range, which can be two different iPhone 12, the iPhone 12 Pro and the iPhone 12 Pro Max. We're expecting Apple to increase the display sizes on the most premium models, although those who want to smolder display still can have an option. Reliable analyst Manchia Kuo's advice that this can be two iPhone 12 versions. The small iPhone 12 is can have a 5.4-inch display, the large one will have a 6.1-inch. We think it is 6.1-inch display, which is the iPhone 12 Pro. The 6.7-inch display, which is the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Unlike last year, however, all models reportedly can be using an outlet display, and the resolution will differ across the range. The 6.1-inch iPhone 12 will likely have a lower resolution than the 6.1-inch iPhone 12 Pro. Mother, are rumors of Apple removing the notch. I really can't see this happening. In typical Apple fashion, was still expecting a full screen display with a notch top center. It's too early for him. Display camera sensors, and I can't see Apple going for a poncho. They also need a time of flight sensor on the front for the 3D face unlocked. While Apple did this, a fingerprint scanner on the iPhone 10, there were reports of this can be coming back in the form of an inch display fingerprint scanner. There are reports suggesting that Apple also can be increasing their refresh rates on the latest displays. While most phones have stuck to 60Hz displays, has been changing recently, and Apple are also going to be joining this trend. At this stage, we don't know if they can be using 90Hz, 120Hz, or even a mixture of the two across the range. When it comes to the rear of the device, we're expecting a similar camera setup to last year. The more premium model will have more cameras. Manchia Kuo has again advised that both the iPhone 12 Pro, the iPhone 12 Pro Max can be adding time of flight cameras to the RAM. For those unaware, time of flight cameras of 3D depth cameras than what Apple uses on the front for the 3D face unlocked. The Time-of-flight sensors on the way, however, use slightly different technology that allow it to map 3D objects from further away. This significantly improves augmented reality applications that allows for more improved portrait-style photo and video effects. We're likely going to see slight upgrades on the other cameras of the iPhone 12, but given the great performance and its predecessor, they will be changing things too much. Reports suggesting that the two more budget models again have a dual camera setup with the iPhone 12 Pro, and the iPhone 12 Pro Max can have a quad camera setup with the inclusion of the 3D depth camera. The iPhone 12 is of course can be powered by the new 814 Bionic processor. This is actually manufactured using 5 nanometers lithography, which will bring significant improvements. There's a good chance that it will be the first 5 nanometers chipset to hit the market when it comes around. The iPhone 12 Pro Max is expected to come with 6 gigs of RAM, with the standard iPhone 12 will only have 4. This is something that I think Apple actually do well compared to Android manufacturers. They throw an unnecessarily large amount of memories, causing the consumer to pay for memory that they don't even need. When it comes to storage, we're expecting a choice of 64, 256, 05, 12 gigs of internal storage. For the first time ever, consumers felt Apple did a great job in prioritizing the battery life of the predecessor, so hopefully that's something that's going to continue with the iPhone 12. For graphing batteries is still out of the question. We can expect a 5.4-inch iPhone 12 around 2,800 mAh, the 6.1-inch is probably to be around 3,150, the 6.7-inch should contain a rent of 4,300 mAh battery. One thing that is a little unknown at the moment is of course 5G connectivity. Apple are very bad when it comes to 5G thanks to earlier issues with Qualcomm to run toward this stage. If that's something we will see in the iPhone 12, is rumored that the iPhone 12 can have 5G connectivity. There aren't actually any leaks or reports to back that up. The iPhone 12 can be IP68 well to resist, and it of course cannot ship with iOS 14. When it comes to the price, people wanted lower prices, and that's exactly what we getting. A few surprises. Last time they surprise us again with the iPhone SE, and now the iPhone 12 is going to be the same. We'll be getting the base 5.4-inch iPhone 12 starting at $649, the iPhone 12 6.1-inch at $749, the iPhone 12 Pro 6.1-inch at $999, finally the iPhone 12 Pro Max 6.7-inch phone at $1,099. Some very reasonable prices from Apple, who have clearly been focusing on keeping the cost down. Of course, it's not all about specs. More likely to see some new software features or improvements to the current features in iOS 14. The iPhone 12 is set to launch in September. As always, it's always around the second week they released 3. Can expect to see the iPhone 12 range or either the 8th or 15 September. The iPhone 12 be released about 10 days afterwards, of course being so far away these Alex rumors, but as more information comes to light, I'll be sharing with you guys straight away as way. So I'd like to know your thought in the comments. To others waiting for the Apple iPhone 12, what model you waiting for, and when you think it's actually can be released? Please subscribe, like the video or comment. Thanks for watching, see you on my next video. One peace out.